Hi, I'm David. My wife Ashley asked me to come on and discuss the reasons that I originally went vegan, to which I transitioned back to vegetarianism and transitioned again back to veganism. So today I am going to talk to you about me for a little. I grew up, my grandparents had a farm and I always helped them on the farm. I'd milk the cow, I would brush the animals, I would feed them, I would get the eggs from the chickens, and I never participated in any slaughter of anything, and I wouldn't have either, but I did participate in the loving and basic cruel utilization of animals. So I guess from a young age, it was given to me the thought that yes, what we did was right, and eating the animals' eggs and drinking the milk of the cows was right, eating the animals that were slaughtered, even though they rarely did that at their farm, was right. They did milk their cows, so that was obvious that they would sell their calves to other farmers, and I never thought anything of it, like veal now that I know that. But at the time I was just thinking, no, they don't need another cow, so they're just selling the cow to for another farmer to bring up. What's funny about it is they made their own milk, they pasteurized it themselves, they churned their own butter, we made homemade ice cream. But it's funny, I could eat the eggs from a store and I could drink the milk from the store, although I never liked plain white milk on anything. I despised it. I thought it was disgusting, and it wasn't because I associated it with animal abuse. It was just, I don't know what it was. I just did not like it. And I think subconsciously I did associate the produce that was prepared on their farm with animal abuse because I could not eat their products, couldn't eat their butter, couldn't drink their milk, couldn't eat their eggs. And I just thought it was gross. I didn't know why, but I just always had this feeling that it was wrong to do it with their eggs. But again, the things that we get from the grocery store, we are so misled and misinformed from such a young age, we tend to disconnect ourselves from the animal and the process in between the animal and the product which they prepare in their stores. So that's just a bit to give you an idea. I grew up hunting. I was always eager to go out with my uncle and uncles and go hunting, fishing, but I could never bait a hook even. I could not put a worm on a hook. I couldn't get a fish. I could not kill the fish. My uncle used to stick the fish through the gills with a branch to hold the fish while we continued fishing, and I thought that was disgusting. There was a connection there for me, and even though I continued participating because I was a youth, I was very young, like these are the ages 5 to 12, that I thought it was wrong to think it was wrong because I had no one to talk to. Everyone that I knew was brought up in a similar background, and I went hunting, and I never shot anything until one time my uncle shot a crow, and it was completely unnecessary to shoot this crow. But he shot the crow and he refused to finish it off, so I had my pellet gun and I had to shoot the crow in the head about a dozen times until it died. And it was because he would not finish it off with the shotgun that he shot it with, and I could not leave the animal there suffering. I had to put it out of its misery, but I didn't know what to do. So I sat there and I just remember tears welling in my eyes as I'm trying to shoot this crow to death so that it won't feel the pain. And that was the first time I killed anything myself. And I continued to go with him, but I never had the urge to shoot anything after that. However, I set snares with my grandfather as he was developing Alzheimer's. I guess at this point we weren't sure if it was dementia or Alzheimer's, but we knew that his mind was going a little bit. So to kind of have one last connection with him, we went quadding and set up snares, and we went down and checked them every day. And about a week later, I found a rabbit snared, and it was frozen to death. And I had to take the rabbit back, and he was so excited, but I just had this sickening feeling in my stomach, and I felt like shit. I cannot say anything other than that I felt so bad for what I had done, and I felt like the world would collapse around me, but of course it didn't. However, I think it's odd that I grew up within this environment and I continued to have this connection in such a disconnected environment that no one else had. I had no one to talk to about it. I just felt like a freak, a black sheep, being so far different, thinking so many different things that I thought about the process. And again, I still had no one to talk to. So it wasn't until grade 11 that I had first gone to a free range chicken barn, and this was in Nova Scotia. That's all I will say about its location. It was in the Valley, Nova Scotia. Again, free-range chickens. And what it was one of those giant steel buildings that you see that looks like it could be an airport, air hangar, sitting in the middle of a field. And we went in, and there were chickens, little baby chicks, just filling the barn. There was no free range about it. They were all pressed against your legs as you walked in. There were so many of them. And the workers came in and they said, "Here, let's make some room." So they started kicking the chickens out of the way. And then one of the workers stomped on one of the baby chicks and ground it with his boot into the ground. And I had to get out of there, so I was just like, yeah, well, I'm going outside. And I left my other friend who was in there looking around with them. And eventually he came out, and we later in the day went to another pig farm, which the building was very similar. It wasn't as tall for some reason as the other barn, but it had these giant tanks on the back of it. I'm assuming that it's probably where they put the pig shit. And they just keep it in these tanks with the nozzles. I'm not sure if it was shipped away or it was probably just taken to another farm and sprayed over their crops like you hear in other movies. I don't know for sure, so I'm not going to say for certain about that. However, when we went in, there was this giant pig sitting out side of the door that led into the pig barn, and it was breathing heavily, just laying there. You could tell it was sick. And we went in and we just looked at the hogs, and they looked miserable. They were all bloodshot eyes, and they looked almost evil because of the disgusting environment that they were forced to live in. And we came out, and one of the workers came over and said something to the effect of, "Hey, check this out, this is pretty fun." And he starts jumping on the carcass of this sick pig, this pig that was dying, that he explained had to be removed because they weren't sure if it was contagious or not. And in order to prevent the spread, they had to risk it and bring it out and let it die outside. But he just jumped on it until you could hear a crack where the rib cage just cracked. And no bones penetrated or anything, but you could see massive bruising caused from internal bleeding. And this pig that was dying, being tortured. And again, I had no idea what to do. But the next day, I went vegan, actually. From that day forth, I realized that I had a different level of compassion than the majority of humans who are sheep. They are nothing more than that, and I like sheep, just not humans. But they don't have the compassion, they don't have the common sense, they don't have the intellect to understand the connection between all living creatures. I realized that I had a deeper connection than the majority of humans, and that's our cat that won't stop meowing, and she's a little crazy. But I had a deeper connection with these animals. I was able to distinguish the differences and the similarities between our species, and I was able to identify that they can feel pain, that they go through as many hardships as we go through, maybe not the same extents levels that we have, but most of our problems are caused by ourselves, and most of their problems are caused by us. So where we give them so little room to make choices and define themselves, we call them animals. We call them, say they can't do anything because we force them not to do anything. That is something that we've taken from them. We've taken what makes them unique from them and domesticated them and beat them into submission for our own use and profit. And I understood this, and I have been vegetarian / vegan. I'm completely vegan now, and I have remained vegan for the past 3 years, and I've remained vegetarian since 1999, and it's something I will never go back to. I think people that choose to adopt the lifestyle of the meat industry, dairy industry, I think that they are not intelligent. I think they're very stupid, and I think that they have no common sense, and I think it's a battle for control within themselves. They want something that they can abuse and force into submission because they're sadistic masochists, and it's the only thing that makes them feel like they are unique, because they don't have that intelligence, that compassion, that evolutionary step that many of us vegans have embraced. And I honestly feel that we are the next breed of human. We are evolved. We almost more primitively go back to coexisting with the animals. However, it takes a much more in-depth intellect to accept and acknowledge these differences as positive benefits rather than control and prosperity. Thank you.